there's an expectation that we need to retain and understand that while God is our defender and he is there to save us, there will still be some times where we go through difficulties and tribulations and persecutions and times where it's going to look like the enemy wins. And maybe in a short-term sense or a short-term perspective, they do win, right? If you consider maybe being cast into prison, oh, the enemy prevailed. Yeah, on a real short scale, they did, right? But those are the moments where you might be questioning and going, where's God? Similar to, you know, John the Baptist, when he was cast into prison, and he said, you know, he sent his disciples to ask Jesus, art thou the one that we're looking for? Or do we look for another? Right? He doubted and had a moment of doubt because of him being arrested and put into prison, and also probably just from a false understanding of what he thought the Savior was going to do when he came the first time. And see, we as New Testament believers and having have all the scripture completely at our disposal and all the time to study it and, excuse me, and learn from different teachers, we've got a lot more understanding than they did back then. Going with just Old Testament knowledge, you know, there's prophecies of Jesus Christ's first coming and second coming, both in Old Testament. So being able to discern between both was harder for them to do. They didn't have as much light shed on the word as we have today. So a lot of the Jews at the time that were looking for a Christ, looking for the Messiah, were looking for the Christ to come and then to set up his kingdom and to rule and reign. And that's what they were, a lot of them were looking for. And that's why I think John the Baptist had a lapse of faith, just going like, well, wait, if he's the Messiah and every, you know, and at first it's great, there's all the miracles, people are getting saved, but then it's just kind of like, well, why am I in prison then? Right? Like, I thought, when are you going to set up the kingdom? You know, when are you going to deliver us from all of our enemies and, you know, and kick Rome out of here and get, you know, and just set up your kingdom, right? So I think that's where some of the doubt came from. It's just a lack of understanding. But of course, Jesus answered him, hey, the blind of receiving their sight, the deaf hear, the poor of the gospel preached unto them, you know, just let them know, remind him, no, I'm still the right guy, right? But he just didn't have a good understanding of what all is to come and what everything is going to entail. So keeping that same perspective is important for us as well, you know, that we can't, you know, life is not going to be a bed of roses. And when people portray Christianity as just being like, oh man, you know, because on the one hand, it's absolutely 100% true. You know, all of your problems are solved when you go to Christ, in the sense that like your worst problems are definitely solved because you're not going to go to hell anymore. And if you look at it from in comparison to every other problem you might possibly have, what else is there when you know that you're saved from hell, you're saved from the punishment of your sins, and that you have eternal life? But on the other hand, you know, you can't take that truth and just apply it in the sense that like, well, you're not going to have any troubles or trials in this life, and any, you know, of course you will. So we need to understand that as well. And it's not necessarily a matter of God forsaking you when you go through hard times.